cheerful musician and listening to his message of hope, it's hard to imagine this 35-year-old once struggled with depression. Meet Dr. Benny Prasad from Bangalore, India. He holds the world record for traveling to the highest number of countries in the shortest period of time. How long did he take to accomplish the feat? 6 years, 6 months, and 22 days. There are 245 different stamps in his passport, some repeated. This was obtained at Antarctica, the coldest continent on Earth. A memorable stop that Benny recalls with fondness, Pitcairn Island in the South Pacific, one of the most remote and least populous places in the world.
I reached there by boat. It took me about 2 days from Mangareva in French Polynesia. I got to do a performance for 52 people in that country. And it was the first ever concert, they said, that in around 200 years.
Featured on television and in newspapers across the globe, the talented musician has performed almost everywhere he traveled, including at international events like the FIFA World Cup and Olympic Games. Along the way, he's met several heads of state. Among his strategies for successful globetrotting,
the biggest challenge for any traveler is loneliness. I was able to overcome because I stay with people. I stay with families everywhere I go. I don't stay in hotels unless it's the law of the land. Fellowshipping with people, living their lifestyle and enjoying the culture.
Another tip, he sleeps well on flights, avoiding jet lag. Benny is the inventor of this unique instrument called a benta. It merges a guitar with bongo drums and a 14-string harp. The composer traveled widely with it, focusing on promoting peace and hope through his music. In late 2009, he realized that breaking a world record was an accomplishment well within his reach. And just before the start of the new decade, he made history. Determined not to pay a single bribe, the musician was sometimes made to wait at borders or blocked from performing. But the devout Christian wouldn't have it any other way. Born into a high-achieving family, he was once called a worthless and useless child because his grades were poor and he suffered from extreme ill health.
I was born with asthma, and at the age of 2, I was given high dosage of cortisone steroids, which I took for 14 years, which damaged 60% of my lungs, and my immune system broke down. I was a failure completely. Everyone said that you will never be able to fly. So my dream was to go to one country in my lifetime.
Today, he is the pride of his family, and he is always ready to encourage those who are battling low self-esteem.
I'm a very ordinary person. I'm not a great musician or a great personality, but I just want to tell you that if God could use an ordinary person like me, today he has a plan for your life.
His music is really amazing, and especially he's very skillful.
I was very, very touched by his story.
I have never seen an instrument like the one he used.
I want to thank God for giving me this opportunity to be here. And it's so nice to be back home and do something here in my own place where I was born and brought up here in Bangalore. And nowadays, you know, I get all kinds of calls for various reasons. This morning at about 12, I got a call from US saying, Benny, there's a team that's been held and they're stuck in Mombasa in Kenya. Do you have any other contacts, someone who can help them? And so I had to just find out some contacts in Mombasa and Nairobi so they could be transported to this place. And but in my travels, I've really enjoyed talking to various kinds of people, from people, heads of the countries, to people on the street and small children, to all kinds of places. But I just want to go by one of the stories that I've enjoyed talking about education. You know, I was thrown out of school, kind of. Well, they told me that you can't stay anymore. From my second standard onwards, every year they pushed me to the next class because the teacher didn't want to keep me in the same class anymore. That was the only reason I was promoted to another class. And they said that you are worthless, you are useless, you are good for nothing, you can never study. And these were the things that were grilled into my mind throughout. And I was born to a father who was an aerospace scientist, and you can imagine the expectations that came out of that. And, you know, I challenge parents, I challenge the society is to think that the children are humans and they're not machines, that they can produce what they want. And many times we have forgotten that in our society. It was tough for me to grow up with that kind of an expectation. And it went on and on and on. At 16, I was at the verge of committing suicide. I did not want to live anymore because everywhere people told me, you are useless. Now, I will carry on my story later on about what happened at 16. But today, I'm taken to those educational institutions to go and share something valuable to them. One of them was this, this was in Bermuda. And here I was taken to the most notorious school, and they asked me to speak to 120 students in two batches. And it was really challenging to talk to these children because they were, most of them are fatherless society. So they don't really listen to anything that happens. But when I went and spoke to them for 1 hour, these children sat down and listened so quietly, so intently. And I was just amazed that their discipline was so beautiful. So immediately they called the news channel, because this was something that new, something new happened in their school. So the news came and they covered up the second session that I did for the second batch of students. And the news went immediately in the afternoon edition, and the Ministry of Education in the parliament called up the school and said, we want to have a half an hour chat with Benny. So this was the people of the Ministry of Education asking, what did you do to keep these children quiet and listen so well? And I told them that it is not just about academics that matter, but it is also the spiritual life and the moral life of a student that really matters. And I want to challenge each and everyone here that your life is more than an expectation. It's more than just a relationship out there. And sadly, in India, in the year 2006, we have had 16 students committed suicide every day, most of them from educated backgrounds. Bangalore is becoming a hub or a main port for suicide. Why? Even in technological places it is, and it's a challenge. And today I address this situation everywhere I go, that your life and my life is much more valuable than just an expectation. And in my travels, this is something that I really share a lot. I never thought that I would be able to fly. This was beyond my imagination that I would ever travel. My dream was to sit in an aeroplane, and later on I thought I could expand my dream of going to one country in my lifetime. But, you know, God had such an amazing plan for me that he said, I'm going to take you to every country by 2010. And well, that's my divine vision which I had from God. And so I carried on with this, and it was great to do that, but it was challenging. It was not easy at all. Well, today this is how my passport looks, and maybe I can just put that. That's one passport. And this passport is my travel record to 250 countries up to date, actually. And I've been able to travel to every country, never took a bribe, never gave a bribe, and never asked for money, never borrowed money. Every single concert I've done has been free of cost. And I've never been in debt. And God has been my faithful provider. And people have seen the genuineness of my travel and my purpose. I don't travel to do sightseeing. And, well, this is how my world map looks today. And these are the routings that he has done. And I'll tell you that it is possible for us to make a difference in this world. It is not all about money. You know, the first trip that I did, I had to break this passport into two pieces because it's not fitting into the machines anymore. But the first trip I did was to my first international concert tour to Russia and then to Latvia and Eastern Europe. And they deported me back in February 2002. And I was told that you have to pay money. I said, no. And what do you do in terms of success? Do you find a shortcut? I've been held in borders for 3 hours, 4 hours, not allowed to perform because in Africa, they just want $1. It is not about the amount. It is about the value that matters. And I've been held there. I remember going from Mozambique to Swaziland. I was held there for 3 hours. And after that, they sent me back because I was not willing to pay that $1. I went back. I was willing to let go of my concert, but not my character. If each one of us take a stand like that, we will see our nation completely transformed. We will see our nation completely different. We can become a role model to others. I have taken my Indian passport. And I'm proud of my country. You know, I've not gone and taken a US citizenship or some other citizenship. I have no problems with that. But people suggested me, four countries offered me citizenship. I didn't take that. I said, I'm going to stick to my Indian passport because God created me like as an Indian. My friend asked me, Benny, do you know God loves India? I said, why and how? He says, he loves India so much that he created so many Indians all over the world. And it's so beautiful to think that. And then, why should I run away with challenges? Yes, it is tough to get visas. I've been held so many. I have stories just about visas. I did not give up. And today, I'm so proud to carry my Indian passport all over the world. Break this world record. People love to travel. They would come and say, Benny, I thought I was traveling a lot till I met you. And I use this as an opportunity to go and speak values into lives of people, values into the nation, saying your passport is, you can make a difference with your passport. If you stand up for truth, if you stand up for justice. I stood up for justice. I stood up for truth. I did not give up. Some of those travels are so extensively difficult, especially when plane goes bankrupt. What do? A one-hour flight takes me 17 hours by road and by boat. I did not give up. And I have physical problems. I have issues with my health. I was born with asthma. At the age of 2, I was given wrong medication. For 14 years, I was on high dosage of cortisone steroids. At 16, they found out that 60% of my lungs have been damaged. My immune system broke down. There was no more life left in me. I was down in line to die next. 6 months was given to me. How do you plan your life when you have 6 months to live? I didn't want to even live for 6 months. And I wanted to kill myself at 16. And that's when I had an encounter with Jesus. And I heard the voice saying that even though you are called useless, I still need you. And I can transform your life and make you a new person. And today, I thank God for the new life that He has given me. That I travel around the world not to make money, not to become famous. It's easy. With this guitar, it's so easy to become famous. With the world record, everywhere the invitations come. 50 countries every year. Right now, I'm only trying to cancel the number of countries of my travels for this year. It's completely booked till the 31st of December. I had to say no to two other TEDx speeches. It's very sad. I wish I could go there and speak. I wish I can cut myself into two pieces and go to two different areas. But I want to tell you that, my dear friends, don't give up. Your life is more precious than just a career, just a dream. No matter how difficult life gets, don't give up. It was hard for me to grow up with so much of expectations coming, being called, you're the black sheep, you're the worst guy. There used to be a saying, no matter how bad you are not totally useless. You can always be used as a bad example. And I was always used as a bad example. No, anything went wrong, you will become like Benny. That's the turning point of anybody else. But here, from there, God picks me up. And if He could give me this brand new life, I'm not after money. It is not after building a career for myself. It is about trying to put a smile on somebody else. That matters more than anything else. Now, I remember going to Antarctica. It was nice to go to Antarctica. Never thought that I would ever go there. This was Commander Carlos, who was one of the key guys who was going to allow me to perform there. Then, it was nice to see the glaciers there, and then the penguins. But the greatest thing was not the glaciers or the penguins. It was really going and sharing a message of joy to these scientists there, thanking them for what they're doing in such a lonely place. And when I went with my guitar and I played a song for them, it brought joy into their faces. They said, you're the first person who has come to give something to us. Everybody else comes for sightseeing tours. And that's what matters today in your life, is when you grow out, when you do different things in life, remember, it is about consider others better than yourself. It is about trying to do something for somebody else. It is a blessing to give than to receive. And today that's what I do in my travels. If it was all about making money, I wouldn't have even traveled to 50 countries. Because it's all about money. So countries that can afford you, you will go there and come. It is not. Money does not decide where I go. My expenses are not based on my income. It is based on my need. Do I need this or no? That is so important. Godliness with contentment is great gain. Today's challenge is, how can we be content in our travels, in our journey here on this earth? And today that's what I do, is to go and make a difference. I'm part of an organization also, one of them is part of Times Square Church called childcrynyc.org. And right now we are feeding 5,000 children in 28 countries every day. 5,000 children every day in 28 countries. So beautiful to feed a hungry child. Sometimes I take these children on the street and I take them to McDonald's. First of all, I have to fight against the authorities there saying, well, they are my guest. You can't say, no, I have braided hair. I look like this Rastafarian, but I don't care how they look at. Take all of them. So beautiful to sit and watch them eat one proper, precious meal. Thinking unconventional is that it's not about how to think about my stomach. It's about how can I make a difference in somebody else. Remember going to one of the restaurants here in Bangalore. There was an old lady sitting out there. And I asked her, do you want to eat something? She said, yes. So she ordered this. And I told them, can you please serve it in a plate? They said, is that for that lady? I said, yes. No, we can't serve it on a plate. We can give it in a plastic cover. No, I said, no way. I had to fight against it, but I lost the battle because they said, you are one among very few people who will do that. Others would not even come to the restaurant, they said. So we are here to make business. But what about the value of that old lady there? That matters for me more than just trying to build a career. We are not talking about how to be heroes in the real, but we are talking about how to be real heroes in the lives of people there. So I went out and I sat with her and I ate. There were people, there were fans who came up to me, autographs, they would want to take pictures. I didn't care of anything. For me, what I did for this old lady matters more and is more valuable than even just trying to win a world record. World record is nothing. There's 5 records actually. I got fed up after the first record, okay, then second record, the youngest man to travel, first musician to travel, first person to build a bongo harp guitar. Okay, what do you get out of these world records? Nothing. A little bit of recognition, probably because of that I'm here. But at the end, it really matters nothing in these things. But today, I just want to tell you that when at the Olympic Games, when I was invited to play for the official welcoming of South African athletes, they strictly told me that you can. I wanted to share my story. When I wanted to quit life, God gave me this new life. There's so many people out there who want to quit. And I knew that with my story, I can make a difference. In spite of doctors telling me you can never play the guitar, if I could play the guitar like this, there is hope for every person there. There's so many people who have come to my concerts with a thought of committing suicide and have gone back saying, Benny, I have hope to live for tomorrow. That matters. That brings more joy to me. That pushes me to travel. In days, one day I'm in 4 countries. Last year, Easter week, I was in 5 continents in 6 days. To push me to go and make a difference in the lives of people. I have one life to live. I don't know how long I will live. 60% of my lungs have been damaged. My immune system is broken down. Many times I can't even climb the stairs up well. But God has given me so much energy. I want to make the best use of the energy that He has given me, the strength that He has given me. So young ones out there, even the older ones, I've read the newspapers of how even businessmen and scientists are at the verge of committing suicide. Why? Your life is more precious. Your life is more than just a business transaction. Please don't give up. You were created for a purpose. You were created to be a blessing. Just because there's a broken down relationship doesn't mean you have to go and end your life. No, please. Your life is very precious. And you have been given an opportunity like this year to study, to grasp so much. Make the best use of what you learn to make a difference. So enjoy this piece called Shout to the Lord, which I played at the Olympic Games.